Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him. Ooh,
and heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
Welcome. Thanks for joining me on this Christmas video message. I hope you listened and watched the video, Joy to the World. This is one of my favorite Christmas songs that tells the story of the birth of Jesus, the real reason for the season. Over the years, I've had the opportunity to share Christmas messages in various churches, including my time at Eden Valley Church of the Brethren out in the country near St. John, Kansas. The Christmas season at this church was wonderful in that we celebrated all the month of December with regular Sunday services that included the lighting of the Advent wreath. We also had a Christmas Eve candlelight service. One of our acts of service to the community was what we called the blessing boxes. We blessed up to 30 families each year in the Stafford County with groceries and gifts and delivered those boxes in mid-December. We included enough groceries for 3 weeks of meals and gifts for the children in the family. Our recent Thanksgiving lunch as a fundraiser for Faith in the Workplace reminded me much of the Blessing Box ministry from that church. I want to thank you for being involved in that. We're going to be able to bless 11 or 12 families within the PRMC family. I want to take this opportunity to share a message of hope and encouragement this Christmas season. We decided to provide this message through video so that you could watch and listen to it at your best time during this holiday season. The phrase that I'm using, "Are you taking care of your heart?" is a phrase that many of you hear me asking as I am in contact with you in the hospital. The reason I think this question is important to all of us is that in the time we're living and the various jobs we are performing, we need to keep ourselves healthy. That being healthy is not only physically, but emotionally and spiritually as well. If we focus just on the task that we are performing, we might get depressed. But if we focus on taking care of our hearts, we will find the energy to perform those tasks. The joy that comes from the energy that God can provide us will keep us healthy and able to care for our families, our patients, and our coworkers. I want to share a rather lengthy passage of Scripture as a major part of this message about taking care of your heart, out of Matthew 6, verses 19 through 34. "Do not lay up for yourself treasures on earth where moth and rust destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven where neither moth nor rust destroys and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also." I don't know about you, but when I focus so much on the money that I make through my job, I may lose my way. What I mean by that is, if I'm so focused on the money I make and the trinkets that I might purchase with that money, I'm not nourishing my soul with the fruit of my labor. When I focus on what that treasure can do for my family as well as for others, my heart is healthy. Continuing on with the reading, "The eye is the lamp of the body. So if your eye is healthy, your whole body will be full of light. But if your eye is bad, your whole body will be full of darkness. If then the light in you is darkness, how great is the darkness? No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money." So another way to stay healthy is to take care of my emotions. Listen to these words of Scripture. "Therefore I tell you, do not be anxious about your life, what you will eat or what you will drink, nor about your body, what you will put on. Is not life more than food and the body more than clothing? Look at the birds of the air. They neither sow nor reap nor gather into the barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not of more value than they? And which of you, being anxious, can add a single hour to his span of life? And why are you anxious about clothing? Consider the lilies of the field, how they grow. They neither toil nor spin. Yet I tell you, even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. But if God so clothes the grass of the field, which today is alive and tomorrow is thrown into the oven, will he not much more clothe you, O you of little faith? Therefore, do not be anxious, saying, 'What shall we eat, or what shall we drink, or what shall we wear?' For the Gentiles seek after all these things, and your heavenly Father knows that you need them all. But seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added to you." I can tell how I'm doing by thinking about what I've been focusing on. For instance, if I don't take time to ask God how to use the blessings he has given me, then those blessings seem to fade away, and I'm left with anxious thoughts. But if I approach God by asking him how I should use the money that I've earned, and if I have a plan in place to use those funds, I'm at peace. Continuing with the reading, "Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow. For tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble." When I'm at peace by focusing on just today, I'm able to give my challenges over to God's care and control. When I worry about what might happen, I take God out of the picture. In the practical sense, when I take back control of my life from God by doing my own thing, it gives opportunity for anxiety to run right into my heart. My encouragement is that we start our days with prayer and keep our days going with prayer and end our days with prayer. Here's some more Scripture to give us the hope we need to stay in the daily battles of life. From Psalm 37, "Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and befriend faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord, trust in him, and he will act." Psalm 51, "Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me." And Psalm 139, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. and see if there's any grievous way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Now, I'm going to include a video by Ricky Skaggs following the closing prayer, and I want you to watch it. But let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for this season. We thank you for giving your son as a baby and as a savior. We thank you for giving us relationship with others so that we can help those with needs. Help us to focus on you to take care of our families, to take care of our friends, to take care of ourselves. Help us to run to you in prayer to keep us calm in all situations. Thank you, Father, for this day and the days to come. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hail, blessed morn, see the great mediator down from the regions of glory descend. Shepherds, go worship the babe in a manger. Lo, for a guard the bright angels attend.
Say, shall we yield him in costly devotion, fragrance of Edom and offerings divine, gems of the mountain and pearls of the ocean, myrrh from the forest or gold from the mine.
Brightest and sons of the morning, dawn on our darkness and lend us thine aid. Star in the east, the horizon adorning, guide where our infant Redeemer was laid. Shining low lies his bed with the beasts of the stall. Angels adore him in slumbers reclining, wise men and shepherds before him do fall. Wise men and shepherds before him. Guide where our infant Redeemer guide where our infant redeemed.